So let's begin with Kurukshetra October edition, and this focuses on the agricultural reforms. Now, a lot of agricultural reforms we had already gone through. Here are the list of some of the major reforms, which are basically the credit Kisan card. We have focused on organic farming, e-naam, which is one of the major schemes that we would focus on. Now, predominantly, India is an agricultural economy. We have more than 50% of the population, which is heavily dependent on agriculture, and you have several number of small and marginal farmers which are part of this process. You have numerous schemes that have been released. Now, when we focus on doubling the farmers' income 2022, we have certain objectives in mind. The first is bringing a thrust to non-agricultural activity. So moving the farmers away from the agricultural activity. For example, Kusum scheme, where farmers can generate additional energy and so sell those to DISCOM. The remaining energy can be used in the farm itself. We are also focusing on an income approach which talks about higher productivity. When we say higher productivity, we are trying to reduce the cost of cultivation, bring out good remunerative prices that are there. Also, we are increasing the production base. So you have the National Food Security Mission, Mission for Horticulture, Oilseed and Oil Palm Mission, reducing the cost by means of soil health cards, Krishi Sinchayee Yojana, where we are talking about more crop per drop, and then we are talking about Har Khet Ko Pani, that is water to each and every field with irrigation supply chain systems that should be maintained. Similarly, for the farmers, we have Pradhan Mantri Krishi Kisan Samman Nidhi, which provide assistance to the small and marginal farmers, and that is by amount of 6,000 per year that would be provided. Kisan Mandhan Yojana, which is also a payment of pension of ₹300 per month to the small and the marginal farmers between the age group of 18 to 40 years, they can contribute and they would get a pension after 60 years. So this monthly contribution can vary from farmer to farmer. Also, to give them the best prices, you have the e-naam scheme, which is the electronic national agricultural market. Now here we have one nation, one market. The idea is that we have numerous grams, which are the rural hearts, grameen agricultural markets, which have been established. Agricultural produce marketing committees have been set up. Minimum support price has been given by the government and has been notified. To check out the risk, we have Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana as one of the schemes. Mission Organic Farming pertaining mainly to the Northeast. Sikkim has been working exceptionally good and has been the first state to have organic farming. Har Met Par Ped has been launched in 2016-17. The idea is to encourage tree plantation along with the cropping systems that are there. We are focusing on National Bamboo Mission, converting the lives of the people in Northeast through the supplemental income that could be generated through Bamboo Mission. Beekeeping is again an allied activity that has been given thrust. Similar to that, we have been focusing on dairy sector, livestock development. India is home to nearly 1.6 billion people, that is targeted by 2035. So there would be definitely a rise in the demand, but with the finite resources that we have, we would have to understand how these crops could be becoming much more productive. So increasing the productivity is another important aspect, and that could come only and only in place through the better research and development. So R&D sector giving thrust to genetically modified technology, genetically modified crops is again important. Water stressed areas need to be taken into consideration, where micro irrigation schemes, drip irrigation, sprinkler irrigation should be brought about. When we talk about fertilizers, we are moving from the synthetic fertilizers to the organic fertilizers, biopesticides. We are also talking about the commercializations of the industrialized crops that are taking place. Soil health card is again one of the unique schemes where we are analyzing the quality of the soil, and based on that, the appropriate fertilizers must be given to the soil. Sarangi committee is important committee because it focused on to the government interventions for agricultural land leasing and the interest subvention that should be taken into consideration. So sometimes you have questions related to committees that are directly asked. When we focus on the harvest, it's not just the harvest that we have to focus on, but the post-harvest mechanisms. So under the post-harvest mechanism, what needs to be taken into account is the shelf life, better facilities for conservation of the crop, and keeping the crop for a longer period. minimizing the price shocks that could occur because of the erratic monsoons that could be there, to make Indian farmers much more competitive at a global level. So bringing in more technological advancement, farmer produce organizations, agro-allied activities that could be grown, and small-scale sectors that could flourish with this is important. So we focus on three things, which is three I's: information, intelligence, and interaction. You have reports that have come up with the 100 days of economy that India has shown, and we are focusing about a 5 trillion economy from India. We have done numerous efforts in those sectors, but initiatives in agriculture have been really, really important. If we look onto the statistics, India is the second largest producer in terms of rice, wheat, groundnut, sugarcane, and cotton also. We are also among the leading producers of fruits and vegetables. So with definitely so much that we have, there are important ideas that we need to focus on for better export facilities. So storage facilities, modern technologies, irrigation facilities are some of the things that we need to specifically focus on. Government schemes are important because those provide a definite path forward for development. As we have already talked about these schemes in the previous sections, those are some of the schemes. Besides that, one important scheme is Kisan Credit Card. This encourages digital payment for credit facility, and this credit facility can be used for agricultural input. You have National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. Now, this was launched back in 2014-15. The idea was to bring in more productivity in the agricultural sector, to bring in specific growth and moisture conservation practices that could be there with sustained livelihood, and to protect the crops from any natural calamity, and moreover resilient crops which can stand extreme weather conditions. So what are the techniques that we focus on agriculture? The first is the conservation agriculture. Now, this is an important idea where we are focusing on the challenges that are there, that can be due to climate change, that can be due to depletion of soil health, reducing the crop yield, degradation of the land, or environmental pollution. So there are three major aspects that we focus under conservation agriculture. First is minimum soil disturbance should be there. The second is to maintain a permanent cover of the soil. And the third is to bring in more variety, so crop rotation and systematic diversity becomes important. The next important method is integrated farming system. So integrated farming system is mainly done in the areas where rainfall is 500 to 700 millimeters. The farming is along with the low water requirements, you have livestock that is being reared, and where you have higher rainfall, you switch on to horticulture and livestock farming that is there. So focusing on diversification of crops and intensification is important. We are also talking about nutrient management. For that, we have a 5R approach, which is right time, you have the right amount at right place with right source and right manner that should be put up. And with the site specific nutrient management, you have lot of feeding crops with nutrients that can actually come up. We are focusing on neem coated urea, biofertilizers, leaf color charts have been prepared, which talks about the chlorophyll meters that can be used, reducing the wastage of nitrogen fertilizers. We are also talking about fertigation, which is a kind of efficient method for applying the fertilizer to the plant, and it ensures that there is uniform distribution of the fertilizers that goes, reducing the use of chemicals that are being used. Zinc as one of the major micronutrient that must be supplied. We are also focusing on organic farming as one of the major issues. So you have small farms that are slowly turning into mechanization, integrated crop management systems coming up. For that, we have a kind of controlled environment which is much more productive. Now, it's not just the role of one gender that is important, but definitely empowering women has led to a revolutionary breakthrough in the agricultural census. So agricultural census, which comes out every 5 years, explains that there has been gender concerns. If those gender concerns are correctly addressed, definitely agricultural sector can boom up. So we are providing support for women food security groups, providing them subsidized rates for agricultural instruments and machineries, inputs that are being used. Also, there are marketing provisions that are there, insurance safety schemes that are there. You have numerous Krishi Vigyan Kains where trainings are being provided. We have Women Farmer Day, which is 15th October of every year that it is celebrated. And we are focusing on social and financial well-being. Also, it's not just the agriculture in the rural area, but you have other public services that need to improve. So housing, health, education, Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas is the idea. We are providing more employment opportunities, more financial resources that could come up. So through the various schemes like LPG, you have the Ujwala scheme, you have the LED schemes, you have Minegra, Manrega, through which you have the employment generation. Creation of self-help groups, Deen Dayal Yojana, Antodaya schemes, you have the Jandan Yojana for financial inclusion. Also, we are talking about women representation in the panchayat. The economically backward areas, mainly the Bimaru areas, needs to be addressed. Also, focusing on the rural self-employment training, which is known as RCT, is important. We are focusing on vaccination through the Indradhanush Yojana, focusing on the Saubhagya electricity scheme for LED, as we already discussed. Sadak Yojana is one of the schemes through which we are trying to have pakka roads to the rural areas. Now, we have for agricultural production 7 important areas that have been identified, and those 7 areas are really, really important. Those are improving the productivity, improving the livestock, bringing in more resource use efficiency, checking out the savings in the cost of production, focusing on crop intensity, diversification and improvement in the price. We are also talking about the neem-coated urea, focusing on micro-irrigation techniques, as we have already discussed. So intensity and diversity of the crop is very, very important. Livestock, as we have already discussed, but all this has come actually through ENAM. The performance of ENAM has really transformed a lot of scenario in the agricultural section, where we have unified the national market, one nation, one market that we focus on. This portal has more than 150 commodities in 8 languages, and a lot of commodity has been transacted through a transparent system. Any kind of intermediaries have been abolished, so you have regulated trade, fair trade that can be part of the systems. So this is a great solution for the stakeholders. We have the following 150 commodities that are there, of which vegetables, then you have food grains, which contribute a significant amount. So no middleman, less transaction cost that has been there. You have single point of delivery that could be seen. Along with that, we also focus on cooperative farming. So cooperative arrangement, you have public-private partnership. Viability gap funding is important. Maharashtra is one of the models which has adopted the public-private partnership. Other than that, you have Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, which have been working for it. And India, since it's one of the largest growing economy, this model, if work successfully, can be implemented to other parts. So it's the collective power of the stakeholders, mainly in the agricultural system, that is really important. So under the PPP model, we have the following ideas that we focus on: understanding the designing of the partnership, identifying the common areas, how the partnership could be completed, what are the evaluation measures and how we implement those. Under this, we are also focusing on the pro-poor sectors. So we have technological developments that come in. We have technological support in the form of, let's say, biotechnology support for agriculture, which is through the MICO. You have the Indian Institute for Vegetable Research in Tamil Nadu. You have the Coimbatore Institute for Agricultural Research, University of Agricultural Sciences Dharwad, which have been working with transgenic forms of brinjal. Similarly, you have numerous projects coming up with World Bank. Recombinant technologies are coming up, which is mainly the enzyme-linked immuno absorbent assay, which is known as ELISA. So those testing tickets are meant for detecting the diseases, working for gene slicing, Similarly, you have important partners that are coming through the Monteso India Limited. You also have National Institute of Agricultural Extension coming in. The hybrid parent research institutes have been working forward. You have Food Cooperation of India. Knowledge management is important. Farm mechanization, along with that, farmers interest groups. So for that, you have mobilizations of the farmers. Kudumbashri mission is one of the missions where you have self-help groups that are being working mainly for the agro-processing sector. You have World Economic Forum with the new vision of agricultural development through the integrated value chain, which is again important. So public-private partnership projects are important. You have procurement preparation projects that are taken into account. Agricultural development of the agriculture, 30% of the net zone area needs to be taken into account. We have two types of agriculture which actually takes part, and that is mainly the surface irrigation and the overdevelopment of the groundwater that is taken into consideration. You also focus on the various schemes for improvement in agriculture with the micro irrigation and also checking out the labor expenses for the same. So the impact is basically increased area for irrigation, reduced use of chemical fertilizers and overall growth with better water application, better applicability that could be seen, reduction in the weed growth, reduction in the energy consumption that could be taken into account. Also, as I said, non-farm activities have turned really important. So you have food processing. So you have numerous canned fruits, gems, jelly, sauce production that could take place. Skill development activities have taken place. So those are basically connecting the rural areas with the projects that are going through the Bharatmala project, through emphasizing the tribal areas, the backward areas. We can provide development in the specific areas. Also, we are talking about the Kaushal Vardhan Kendra, which is mobilizing the panchayats, improving the skill, and you are talking about the skill development and training programs. So those are some of the important aspects where we talk about improving the scientific temper, fostering kind of innovation spirit that is there. Now, Mahatma Gandhi's contribution has been important. With the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, his contribution to the development, not only in the agriculture but overall, is very, very important. Here we have some of the important points: the Champaran movement, the Kheda movement, and then you have the Tinkathia systems that was challenged by Mahatma Gandhi. So in his autobiography, he mainly focused on a hygienic condition of village that is very, very important. And once you have a good healthy condition, you can have a better development of the village areas that could be seen. Also, we have the Swachh Mahotsav 2019 that was celebrated. So those are some of the important ideas that have been discussed in this Kurukshetra. We'll be coming up with Kurukshetra and Yojana summary every month. So stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.